Look, I could do a really big in-depth intro into the history of the club we're going to be managing, but it's as simple as this. I like eating hamburgers, obviously. That's who we're managing. So before we get into this, let me explain why Hamburg. Basically, it's a club that I've liked for quite a long time. I'm a big fan of the Bundesliga. Obviously, Hamburg are a little bit of a fallen giant. They've gone down into the second Bundesliga and they're struggling to get back up. I stream Football Manager on Twitch, and at the end of FM21, we did a Hamburg save and it was really, really good. We did 10 seasons, got them promoted. It was a bit of a roller coaster. It took us 7 seasons to win a trophy, but in the end, we did win a few in the last 3 seasons. I was going to pick either Frankfurt or Borussia Mönchengladbach, but I just thought Hamburg would be quite fun. We'll get them promoted and we've got to rebuild this fallen giant pretty much from the ground up because they've not really got any good players there at the moment. So looking at the challenge ahead, the main thing is domestic success. Basically, we've got to get promoted back to the Bundesliga. If we don't do that in the first season, then it's a complete and utter waste of time, really. So the key thing is getting promoted, and then we can really start to build. I'm ever so tempted to do the financial takeover just to make it a little bit more interesting. However, I'm willing to keep it quite realistic, so we're not going to be going mad and getting unrealistic players that wouldn't consider playing in the second Bundesliga. The idea is we could get some promising youngsters in and just see if we can develop them on the journey. So I think I'm going to throw in 50 million. We're going to look at this as if we've been taken over, but it's not a ridiculous takeover like a Man City or a Chelsea or Newcastle. It's just somebody that's come in, bought the club for the 100 million it was valued at, and then they decided to throw 50 million in just to make sure that Hamburg can get over the line and get promoted back to the Bundesliga. I think 50 million's reasonable. Obviously, it's sort of given us a bit of a boost, but I'm going to keep it realistic. Oh! Looking sleek! Got me little V-neck jumper on. Now, something I'm going to be doing in this save quite a bit more than I did in the Liverpool career mode is I'm going to be simming a lot of the fixtures, particularly in this first season. We'll play some of the bigger games, the likes of your Nurembergs, your Werder Bremens, Schalke, but we're going to simulate quite a lot of the easier fixtures, if you like, the more boring fixtures, if you want to call it that. And see if we can just plow through this first season as quickly and as efficiently as we can, get promoted back to the big time, back to the Bundesliga, and then we can really start getting into it then. Squad-wise, there's a lot of improvement needed. We're going to have to upgrade quite a lot of positions, I think. But again, I'm going to be doing it in a quite a realistic way if I can, going for a lot of promising youngsters. Also, maybe looking for some experienced Bundesliga players who'd be willing to take the step down. I am thinking we probably need a slightly better goalkeeper. We could do with a bit more of a commanding centre-back. In terms of our fullbacks, we've got 2 decent starting fullbacks in Wagnerman and Leibold for the right and left back. Centre mid, we could do with an upgrade, at least one. In terms of strikers, we're going to look to at least get one decent striker in there, possibly somebody from the Bundesliga who's experienced, just to get those regular goals, 15 plus goals kind of thing to get us promoted. In terms of the formation, I don't normally play with three or five at the back, so we're going to go for that. We're going to obviously have the 2 wide fullbacks, wingbacks playing quite attacking, quite aggressively up and down those flanks. And we're going to look to utilise 2 strikers up there as well. Right, so we've done a bit of scouting and this is the shortlist of players that we're looking to sign from. We've got a couple of goalkeepers, some centre-backs, some centre-mids and some strikers in there. We may look to sign a dedicated cam as well. And I am also going to be selling some of the starting lineup as well. Some players who just aren't quite good enough, the likes of Sonny Kittle, Vince Heimer, I think his name is, we've sold him as well. So I'll show you all that properly in a minute anyway. But yeah, these seem like semi-realistic targets for us. Some people might disagree with that. There's some names that are well known in here, some really decent players as well. Going with the idea that Hamburg have just been taken over in this save, there's a little bit of money there, but not loads, but a little bit more than they had. And there's the promise of we're going to go all out to get promoted, and then we're going to make a good go at establishing ourselves back in the Bundesliga. I think some of these targets are semi-realistic. Let me know what you think in the comments if you disagree, or if you think they're spot on, let me know as well. Let me know I'm doing a good job. So the idea here is, do we go for the slightly cheaper option? Chakir and Lafont are going to cost us quite a lot, a large chunk of our 50 million that we've got. We're not going to make a lot of money off player sales, really. Van der Voort's going to be a lot cheaper, but he's going to need developing. However, that does seem like quite a fun signing, somebody we can develop. and who can grow as we grow. So he's worth 2.8. We'll go in with a nice round 3 million, see what they say. They want 4.1. We'll reduce that a little bit. Every little bit of money that we can save will help us. 3.5, they're happy with that. And that's all fine. Okay, so Van der Voort's across the line. So Stasiou was probably the one that I would have gone for out of all of these, but they're not interested in selling him. So we'll leave him on the shortlist for now. We may go back for him maybe in the winter window. Akhmadzic is a well-known player, particularly on Football Manager. You can get him for really cheap and he grows into an amazing player. I've just had him for 2 seasons at Saint Etienne and bought him for, I think it was about 7 million, sold him for 50. So he's quite a promising player. He's already decent. He's already better than any of the centre-backs we've got. A handbag. I think we should go all out for him. And that looks okay to me. Boom, Akhmadzic in. Next, we'll have a look at the two centre mids we've scouted. Both reasonably priced. Both offer different things. Both tend to be more like a CDM style of player. I'm actually tempted to go for both of these, to be honest with you, as there's going to be a lot of growth for both of them. They both look incredibly promising. I think what we'll do, we're going to go for both of these. So we'll get Boulat on first and then Fernandez. Another one done. And let's go for Fernandez now. That's Fernandez in. Now we come to the striking option. And again, if we can afford two, we'll go for two here. We'll go for two out of the four that we've got listed. Now, the standout one, everybody knows this kid's name. He's got massive potential. Again, from Football Manager and from FIFA Career Mode the last few years. Adam Hlotek. If we can go all out to get this kid, even though he's worth so much, I think that will be a hell of a signing. It might be one of the more unrealistic ones, but then I suppose Hlotek would look at Hamburg as maybe a stepping stone, particularly if he can get back in the Bundesliga. I don't know if we've got enough money to actually go for him, but we're going to try. Right, they want 31 mil. Can't afford that. So we're going to have to get this down quite a bit. This is going to be a big, massive chunk of our transfer fee. That's the only issue I have with this, really. We're going to see if we can do it. I don't even know if we've got the money to do this deal, to be honest with you. I can't imagine him wanting too big of a wage. I think we can do this. Boom. Adam Hlotek coming to Hamburg. It's a risk for both, really. We're hoping he can develop. We've spent a lot of money on him. He's obviously hoping we can get back in the Bundesliga and stay there quite comfortably and eventually maybe start challenging. But yeah, that's Adam Hlotek in. So looking at the finances, we've actually got a decent amount of money left, really. Around 10 million we could spend. So I think we could maybe get one of these other strikers in. Obviously, the cheapest going to be Farias, but I don't know whether he's the one we want to go for again. 18 years old, really big potential. Probably the one worth going for, I'd say. Really fast. João Pedro's a little bit more experienced, but he's going to cost them the most in terms of his wage and the transfer fee. So I'm actually going to remove him. It's not going to be worth it. The question is here, what type of player do we want to go for? This Ketelier has got a little bit more adaptability in terms of the positions he can play. And he's definitely more of a big target man type player. Not really much pace, although decent for a man of his size at 6'4". Farias is, again, more of a small, quick striker. I think, do you know what? I'm going to actually try going for De Ketelier here. We might not be able to afford him. It depends how much he wants. Contract-wise? Yeah, we've not got enough money. We're going to have to end the negotiation on that one. I'm going to hold off on that because I want him more than the other player than Farias. So we're going to move things forward, see if we can get some more sales to go through just to boost our finances a little bit. And we can maybe get that transfer over the line. Okay, so we've agreed a 19 million price for De Ketelier. We've sold a couple of players as well. 3 more players have gone out, each for about 2 to 3 million. And it's just boosted our finances a little bit to hopefully get this deal over the line. Now it's about the contract. Hopefully this shouldn't be too much of a problem. Right, so a decent sized salary. We'll go straight for 20 grand and see if he agrees to that. Done. Okay, and it's just in time because we've now got our first match of the league. And it couldn't be much tougher. Schalke away. Newly demoted, newly relegated. Schalke. Werder Bremen will be another team that's going to be difficult to play against later in the season. But what a really, really difficult fixture to begin with. Going away to Schalke, a tough stadium to go away to. I think they've got a better squad than us overall, having only just gone down. This is going to be a real test. So the way we're lining up, we're going with that three at the back, five at the back sort of thing with the attacking wing backs. We've got Hlotek and Di Ketelaere up front. Bulat is not really a cam, but we're going to deploy him there to begin with. We're going to have to look at getting somebody cheap in, maybe someone we can develop. We've not got a lot of money left, you see. We've sort of thrown it all in on these big signings. We've got Rice in there and Fernandez, one of the new signings. We've got Akhmadzic playing as the left centre-back. Vuskovic, who's probably one of the highest potential players we had at the beginning of the save, the beginning of the game. We've got Ambrosius back there, who's again got decent potential. Obviously the two fullbacks are, you know, they pick themselves really, and we've got Van der Voort in there. We need him to develop and develop quick. So the start of our campaign, couldn't really ask for a much tougher start really. I just hope that as the season goes on, we can at least get automatic promotion, at the very worst maybe getting that playoff match. Oh, and it's a lovely bit of play. Great save from Van der Voort. We're going to need him this season, I can tell you right now. Oh, nice run from Wagner. We're going to whip this back post. Nobody's there. Leibold winning it out wide. That was a nice header in. Oh, it's lovely play. Oh, it's a lovely finish. And I think it's Hlotek, is it? Really nicely played. Really patient. Waited for the gaps. And Hlotek starts our campaign off with the first goal. Lovely ball in from Bulat. And then he just turns as he receives the ball. It's a first time. Finesses it into the bottom right corner. Beautiful. Oh, Farman actually got a little touch to it. But it's a lovely goal from Hlotek. And we're 1-0 up away against Schalke. Can we get a second or at the very least hold on? Let's see. Oh, what a great tackle from Rice. And De Ketelaere's through. He's just going to hit this near post. Oh, it's hit the post. And we're going to go for a little over-the-top ball here. He's going to get to this Hlotek, I think. He's going to lay it back. Oh, it's lovely. Oh, and it's 2-0. And our other striker, De Ketelaere, I hope I'm saying that right, by the way, puts us 2-0 up. It was a great breakaway. Really patient play. All the right passes at the right moments. And it was a really cool and composed finish from De Ketelaere. Hlotek with the hold-up play. And I think it was back to Bulat. And then he's just slotted it into De Ketelaere. And he's put it back across goal into the bottom left. Ralph Farman can't get near it. We're 2-0 up away against Schalke. Sloppy pass, man. He was marked. It wasn't really the right option. Oh, it's a good save from Van der Voort. That looked like that was going in then. And that's half time. We're 2-0 up. It's been quite a close game, though, considering we've just been a little bit more clinical than Schalke. And you can hear the Schalke fans not happy. Oh, we've got into the back of them. And that was a desperate tackle, and it's going to be a penalty to Schalke. Vuskovic going straight in. Catching him on the heel. He's gone down. It's going to be a penalty. I think it might be Terod with the pen. I'm not sure. Yeah. Oh, and it's saved by Van der Voort on his debut for the club, making a penalty save. It's not over yet, though. Ooh, won the header. And we're going to hit it to one of the big boys up front. You're going to hear me say that a lot this season. Oh, it's a lovely overlap. Fernandez is through. Oh, it's a good save from Ralph Farman. Plotzek's just a bit... Oh, he's managed to pick it up, though. He's passed it back and it's gone behind. And they're really throwing numbers forward now. Desperate challenge there. Luckily, Van der Voort, probably our man of the match, I'd say, so far. Good near post save. Okay, so we've made a sub. Just to freshen things up a little bit, we've thrown Glatzel on up front, who's another big guy, not really much pace. We've thrown De Ketelier back into the cam position because he can play it. And we've taken off Fernandez. We've dropped Bulat back into the centre mid. Oh, Schalke have got a free hit here. Good save from Van der Voort. He's collected it. Oh, that's a great header. Oh, Glatzel's played through Bulat. Bulat's through. Oh, it's a lovely slotted finish into the bottom left. And he's had a hell of a game, Bulat. It's basically between him and Van der Voort for man of the match. Both new signings. I'd give it to Van der Voort, but Bulat's making a good case for it. And Glatzel being really patient there, holding it up, waiting for that run. And I think that's probably game over. We're going to throw on Kinsombi for Bulat. Bulat's going to get a nice little ovation from the away fans. And we're going to throw Mulheim on at left back just to freshen one of the flanks up a little bit. Oh, it's a good ball in. Oh, and they pulled one back, Schalke. Surely it's too late in the game for them to come back fully, but that's worrying. And it was a bit of a run from deep to get on the end of the cross. What a way to start this career. A 3-1 win against Schalke, who will be one of our rivals to get promoted. We couldn't really have asked for a tougher first game, I don't think. And we've come out with flying colours. It's a shame we didn't get the clean sheet in the end. But all the new signings making a big impact in this game, particularly Van der Voort, our goalkeeper. Both new strikers getting on the scoreline and Bulat as well, who's basically going to be the captain going forward, the shining talisman, if you like, of the team. Really, really happy with that. Up next, we've got a fixture against Dynamo Dresden, and we're going to be at home. So, first home game of the season. Be nice to get that out the way. And we're going to keep the lineup as was for the first game against Schalke. Everybody performed pretty well. So we're going to look to see if we can just keep that momentum going. The Volkspark Stadion looking good. Looking good. Akhmadzic running up. Nearly losing it there. And they're really pushing us back out here, Dresden. Oh, this is lovely. And we're going to whip this in. And it wasn't quite the cross I was hoping for. I was hoping for back post. Oh, that's lovely play. Leibold available again. He chose to cut back. It could be a penalty. It is a penalty. I thought I'd missed the chance there, to be honest. There was a run at the near post that I should have capitalised on. But luckily, the Dresden fender went in too hard. Leibold trying to turn back behind him. And it's a penalty. And it's Lotzek who's stepping up. And I think what we're going to do, we're going to aim for a nice top right corner finish here, if I can just get a grip of the aim. Oh, it wasn't the best penalty and the keeper guessed it right. Damn it. Yeah, it didn't quite go in the top right corner that at all. It was a nice easy high for the keeper. Bit of space here. Ooh, it could be a penalty. We've got away with it. Ooh, Van der Voort with quick feet there. Oh, and that was a little bit chaotic. I got worried there, I'm not going to lie. Loads of space out here on the left. Leibold making some great runs here. Oh, and he's lost it, trying to cut back. Oh, it's a nice simple play. We're going to play this back, and he's going to hit it first time, and it's a great goal. Lovely link-up play between the two big boys up front. And it's Lotzek, basically 1-2 in it, getting it back and hitting it first time, top right corner, it's right through it. Loads of space, and it was a lovely finish, keeper had no chance. Oh, nearly losing that. Oh, that's going to be an equaliser, straight away, I could see it. And I think a Schroeter with the equaliser. And it was just really quick passing. I couldn't get close enough to react to it. That's half time, 1-1. Pretty even, I'd say, although I kind of feel like we've been under quite a bit of pressure from Dresden on occasion. But we've also looked good ourselves, so I think it's been a pretty even affair so far. Well defended. Oh, there's a little bit of space here. That's lovely. Leibold, he's going to go for it. Oh, near post finish. Well saved by the keeper. And we'll go for a bit of a near poster on this one, I think. Klotzek winning the header, but it was inaccurate. Goal kick. Wagnerman, oh, it's going to be a free kick. And I think what we're going to do, we're actually going to attempt to get this in for one of the big boys to head. Fernandez, oh, somebody took a tumble in the box there. I don't think it was worthy of a penalty though. Oh, and I've committed there for the tackle. And it's gone wide again. They're getting close, Dresden. Oh, good block. And Zombie trying to get that under control. And I think we're going to switch this, or attempt to at least. And we really need to go for this now if we want to get the win. Great tackle there. Oh, they've won it back again. And that's a foul. I just feel like all the momentum's with Dresden here. They're getting all the lucky touches outside our box. And it feels like a goal's coming for them. It really does. Decent free kick, Van der Voort gets it. Ooh, bit of space for Leibold here. And he's whipped it in. Ooh, it's a good header at the back by DK. Using that height and strength. Decent header, did the right thing, headed it down. Keeper had to make a bit of a reactionary save. Oh, look at the space. Wagnerman's got loads of it. And we're going to go for a cross back post. Oh, and he went for the volley, Klocek. It was tackled. Corner, 88th minute. Oh, and it was such a good edit from Meffert. He got himself free. But he's put it wide. Everything about it was perfect. The timing, the power, the sort of height he headed it down to. It just wasn't accurate enough, unfortunately. Meffert's found a bit of space. Oh, and it was so free at the back post. And it was a terrible cross. Number six, I think that's the centre mid we brought on. I can't remember his name now. Kinsombi, he was completely free at the back post there. And it would have been a tap-in. But that was a tough game. In some ways, that felt harder than the Schalke game, weirdly. And Dresden had chances there to definitely score more goals than just the one. I guess we should be glad that we've at least got the draw, we've not lost. Shame to not get a win for the first home fixture. Klocek's penalty was saved. It wasn't a great pen in the end. We don't really have anybody in the squad who's a good penalty taker, to be honest with you. But yeah, 1-1. We'll have to take that. Still unbeaten so far in the first two games. On to the next one. Okay, so up next we've got the cup game, first cup game of the season. But we have just signed somebody, a promising youngster, Saranic, a young Croatian, primarily to be used as a cam. What I'm actually going to be doing is dropping Bulat back into the centre of midfield where he's better alongside Fernandez. And we're going to be playing Saranic in the cam position, see how he gets on there. We've also got a bid in for our backup goalkeeper, Fernandez, just to get a little bit of money and to maybe get one more promising youngster in if we can. We've got a couple of half-decent, low-rated, though, goalkeepers who could do the job. And then we're just going to cross our fingers that Van der Voort doesn't get injured anytime soon. But for this game, we are going to rotate a little bit just to keep people fresh. And we're actually just going to quick-sim this. And it was a pretty straightforward 3-1 win, 59% possession, better on the shots and the chances. And the goal scorers were DK, Glatzel, and Wagnerman in the first half. So not too bad. Next up, we've got an away fixture against St. Pauli. We're going to simulate this one. This will be the last game of the episode. So yeah, going to simulate it, see how we get on. And it was a 2-1 win. Goals in the first half from Bulat and DK. Okay, so two first half goals, and then Becker scored for St. Pauli in the 62nd minute in the second half. And just to end the episode, we've actually just confirmed the signing of a young, really pacey striker who's got a little bit of potential. I don't think he'll become a star. But basically, I needed somebody fast as an option, as an alternative to Klocek and DK. Glatzel, we're going to look to sell him now that we've signed Stoica, because we're not going to need him, hopefully. So Stoica we brought in, we're developing him as a mobile striker. As you can see, pretty quick, really high sprint speed and his acceleration. We're going to look to increase that as well. Relatively cheap as well. We didn't have a lot of money left. We might be able to get one more player of that sort of ilking, but maybe for another position. Again, somebody maybe young and promising who's only going to cost us 1 or 2, maybe 3 million if we can sell Glatzel. Quite happy with the squad. Happy with the start. We've got 2 wins and 1 draw. The next game will be Darmstadt. We'll probably play that at the start of the next episode. Oh, we also went through in the cup as well. Don't forget, I forgot about that. So technically, we've had 3 wins, 1 draw altogether. But yeah, looking good. So far, we're 5th in the league. But we've got a game in hand, so if we win that, we could go top. But anyway, yeah, hope you guys are enjoying it so far. I'm really passionate about this save already. I can't wait to see if we can get back in the Bundesliga at the first attempt. And once we're there, how are we going to stay in there? Because it's going to be really, really tough. This is a club close to me, Hamburg. I've loved them for years. And as I said at the start of the episode, we had a really good run with these on Football Manager, FM21. We did 10 seasons with them and it was a real interesting save, ups and downs galore. But yeah, looking forward to seeing how this develops, this save, as we do it. And yeah, appreciate you guys tuning in. See you again.